Okay, this is Joe at Plum Crazy Restorations. We're here with the 65 Pontiac Crisian, and a lot of problems on this one. Where do we start?
Okay, we'll start off with the air cleaner area. It's just an adapter someone put on there to make an air cleaner work, but it doesn't fit right, so you can see lots of air is going to come up in between here.
Yeah.
So that's the wrong air cleaner canister on there right away, so the air filter isn't really doing its job anymore.
Okay.
You've got some lines that are kind of bent up in crazy ways, and you've got a fuel filter down here that's a plastic one. That's where they like to break and spray gas all over the hot exhaust manifold.
Yeah, for sure. I've had that happen to me before.
And that will cause a fire that's never good.
Okay.
And while we're here, we got hoses that are hard like a rock, so they should really be replaced. They're going to fail as soon as they start to get hot and expand and contract a few times. The lower rad hose, both
so hard
hoses.
They feel like original hoses.
Yeah, they're hard like a rock, top one too. And over here, you can actually see the bottom here transmission transmission fluid lines are actually coming apart as I'm touching it here. I don't want to touch it too much, you won't be able to start the car anymore, but that's transmission line going into the radiator.
Okay.
I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to get this out of the radiator without having a radiator problem. I'd have to put a cooler up front instead.
Okay.
And I recommend another belt. And we'd have to reroute a little bit of hard piping stuff for a vacuum line here. It's got going kind of crazy up here. We can fix this up.
Okay.
And see, the spark plug wires are coming down. It's got ram horn exhaust manifold on them, which are good. That's what a car is supposed to have. But they're actually almost right against the exhaust manifold down here. They're supposed to go behind the exhaust manifold by the block and read them around the right way.
Yeah.
And everything is really close to the exhaust. It's missing the heat shields. We're supposed to have a heat shield here, another one here to stop everything from getting too hot and burning. And while we're here, it's the upper control arm here. And this is the bushing here. And this is the big washer supposed to hold everything in. And you see it's loose. It came in like that, so that's not a good idea. It actually needs upper control arm bushings also. The bushings are weak and they're moving around.
All right.
And let's see now, over this side, we've got pretty much the same idea going on with spark plug wires. Again, we're missing both of the heat shields. This one actually has one proper clip here for two of the spark plug wires here.
Okay.
And the other side, and we've got some over here, but they need to be turned, tucked around a little bit better than that.
Okay.
And it's got...
Does it still have points, or is that a Pertronix in the distributor?
No, that's still points. Okay. That's a point ignition.
Be a good idea to switch that over to Pertronix,
that would be a good idea.
Electronic going on.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Okay, it's still got a single system master cylinder. You never want to lose one wheel, because with one wheel gone, with just a single line coming out of there, that mercy brake better work, otherwise you pretty much jump out.
You call those the suicide master cylinder.
Absolutely. You get in that thing and hope for the best. I wouldn't want to ride there. Okay. And we might as well go underneath and take a look and see what we got there.
Okay, sounds good. Here we go.